contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from El Paso, Texas, weighing in at 215 pounds, Chavo Guerrero.
It has been an amazing night thus far on Friday Night SmackDown. It began with Christian going one-on-one with Sheamus, our main event. The World Heavyweight Champion Randy Orton goes one-on-one with Mark Henry. But what a night it's been.
Man, it's going to be, you know, it's been a huge night. Right now,
you know what's been even better about this night is the fact that we're just two nights away from me making Jerry Lawler kiss my foot Sunday at Over the Limit. That's what's big about this night. Why do you guys get upset with me all the time? I don't understand.
Last week, Sin Cara, you embarrassed me. The truth is that I brought you here to SmackDown, Sin Cara. I brought you here. I taught you everything you know. And that's how you repay me? By disrespecting me? The truth is, you could even beat Daniel Bryan without my help. But I don't need your help, Sin Cara. What took you 15 minutes to do last week, I'm gonna do in under 5. Tonight, I will beat Daniel Bryan in under 5 minutes. And that's a lot less time than I need to beat you, Sin Cara, this Sunday at Over the Limit.
What a Latino ruling, Chavo Guerrero is.
Making his way tonight from Aberdeen, Washington, weighing in at 192 pounds, Daniel Bryan.
Now go ahead, Booker, tell me how Daniel Bryan's all upset because Chavo Guerrero distracted him last week and he lost to Sin Cara, and now he's going to take out his retribution here on Chavo tonight.
Chavo right now seems a little bitter for some reason as far as the success of Sin Cara coming in here right now having the SmackDown audience in awe. It seemed like he was in that place once upon a time, and I think he wants it back.
Let me ask you a question. If you brought someone into WWE, took them under your wing, actually helped them win a match last week, and then they treated you the way Sin Cara treated Chavo, wouldn't you be upset about that?
You know, maybe we was looking at two different things. You know, I saw Chavo actually, you know, interfere in a match where Sin Cara was in total control. Sin Cara didn't want the help, didn't ask for the help, and I think he was just trying to prove a point right there as far as I'm here to do this, and I'm here to do it on my own here in the WWE.
Chavo Guerrero looking to prove another point that he can defeat Daniel Bryan here on SmackDown in less than 5 minutes. A feat that took Sin Cara right around 15 last week, according to Chavo Guerrero.
Goes back to what I was just talking about, the point I was just saying. It seemed like Chavo is a little bit of jealous of Sin Cara's success. I mean, whether it took 15 minutes, whether it took 5 minutes, it really don't make no difference. Sin Cara got the win.
You saw Chavo glancing at the clock, putting the pressure on himself here in this matchup. Chavo extremely confident, however. Wow. What was your take last week? Sin Cara noticed that Chavo Guerrero assisted him in picking up a victory. Sin Cara was really upset about that.
You know, that goes to show you exactly what kind of person he is. I mean, inside, as a man, as an individual, as a performer, he doesn't want to win like that. Sin Cara wants to prove here on SmackDown that he could be the best. And that right there is, I give him big props for that.
Well, you have no problem with Chavo assisting Sin Cara.
Not at all, and I don't understand why Booker does either. Booker, you've won a lot of matches in your career, including championships. Championships because of the help of other people and distraction of other people. Why is that upset? Why does that upset you? I don't get it.
Chavo Guerrero looking here to beat the tag, hooks the leg.
You know, it's not about me and what I've done, Cole. I mean, that person was a totally different person than the person I am now.
Hurt yourself, Daniel.
You know, I can honestly say that. Otherwise, I'll beat him, rip this cold man down, and went in there and commenced to beating the crap out of you.
Another cover here.
You sound like the guy that goes to prison and finds the Lord. Hey, I know who you sound like tonight.
Hey, you know, in some way, it's like that, Cole. Like I said, I'm a different person. I'm in a different stage of my life, Cole, this season. Spring, summer, winter, fall. I'm in my fall
Come
season.
On, Daniel,
I'm having a hell of a good time. Let's go back to this match right
Let's
here.
Go.
Chavo Guerrero forcing Daniel Bryan to take a look up at the clock there. Daniel Bryan looking to get something going here offensively.
Well, Chavo better get something going.
Nice roll through there. Chavo Guerrero uses the momentum boost through Daniel Bryan now in control. Chavo stacked up.
Chavo's looking a little desperate right here. Just get this win in under 5 minutes. Don't get that win in under 5 minutes, Chavo's going to have a whole lot of egg on his face whether he get the win or not.
I think a lot of people were impressed last week by what Daniel Bryan brought against Sin Cara here on SmackDown. Daniel Bryan considers himself a submission specialist.
I consider him a nerd.
Oh. Effective clothesline nonetheless. You know, Booker Daniel Bryan doesn't even own a television.
Cole, we're talking about prison, right? With that physique you got, that little body you got, hopefully you will never go to prison, or you'll be watching somebody's socks.
Yeah, but people say I have prison tattoos.
Jaco Guerrero may be seeing lights right now after that. And you can see Daniel Bryan getting a glimpse of the clock. Daniel Bryan looking to, get the best of Chavo and last the 5 minutes. Chavo, 90 seconds to go. Chavo said he can defeat Daniel Bryan in under 5 minutes. Bryan looking for the lapel lock here against Chavo Guerrero.
Come on, Chavo, fight out of it.
Bryan's signature submission maneuver.
You know, we're talking about Chavo, beating Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan has a hell of a chance to beat Chavo. Daniel Bryan is the real deal. Come
so
on, man.
Chavo Guerrero barely.
You want two.
Drapes his foot over the bottom rope there.
Yeah, but check out the clock.
Yeah, Chavo rolling out right there. You know, trying to create a little space.
60 seconds to go.
That was that moment by Chavo to roll out of the ring there with a clock on him. Watch out.
There you go. Beautiful right there by Daniel Bryan. That's a high-risk maneuver right there. Sometimes it pay off, sometimes it don't. That time, Daniel Bryan cashed in the big ticket.
Come on, Chavo. 40 seconds. Let's go.
Daniel Bryan continues his high-risk. Oh, there we go. Chavo hits the leg with 31 seconds to go now.
Come on, Chavo. 2 seconds.
And Chavo noticing the clock. Has to quicken his pace right now. That's Chavo Guerrero.
Does he have time tonight?
Chavo better go for a cover, and he better do it. And he better do it quick.
Well, he's got 20 seconds. And Chavo Guerrero going to cross flash block. Come on, Chavo.
Chavo in a rush here.
Does he got time?
Back down to just about 10 seconds right now for Chavo Guerrero.
He's got it.
Too much pressure on himself to go out here and beat Daniel Bryan and couldn't get it done in 5 minutes. Maybe Chavo is losing a step or something. I don't know.
I'm quite frankly shocked.
Hey, come on, Chavo, what are you doing?
Chavo,
come on, come on. What are you doing?
He's gonna do it. Now he's going to punish Bryan.
This international sensation.
Sin Cara here to prove that statement right here. Sin Cara's here to show Chavo Guerrero a little bit of something. Give him a taste of his own medicine.
Well, of course, you know, Sin Cara comes out here tonight, pretty much ambushes and attacks Chavo Guerrero. We're going to see come Sunday when it's an even playing field and these two men go one-on-one. What's going to happen at Over the Limit?
Chavo Guerrero is going to have to regroup and refocus for this Sunday because he couldn't defeat Daniel Bryan in the 5 minutes he said he would, and then he got bested by Sin Cara.